Hello everyone, this is the Casual Fan. Now in this video we are focusing on the Abu Dhabi Grand Prix qualifying, well, my reaction to it, and we're looking ahead at the race we have tomorrow. Now, well, first of all, what a lap by Max Verstappen. In many ways I feel, yeah, the toe from Sergio Perez, it did help him, but contributing a deficit of 0.551 seconds just to a toe, it's not bad. That was the driver making the difference, and that was the driver making a difference in a car that had not topped a session since FP1 yesterday. FP2, Lewis Hamilton on top. FP3, Lewis Hamilton on top. Q1 and Q2, both of those sessions showed clear supremacy of Mercedes, and then out of nowhere Max Verstappen comes in and clinches pole by such a gap. But that should surprise people, and in many ways that should be a clear testimony of what kind of a driver we have here. Someone who can pull such a lap time out of nowhere. In many ways we have to respect the craft and the talent and the hard work that goes on behind it. Having said that, we have Max Verstappen starting on pole. We have Lewis Hamilton second. We have Lando Norris in a surprise P3. And then we have Sergio Perez in P4. After that, we have Carlos Sainz in P5. Valtteri Bottas in a pretty disappointing P6. There were probably some engine issues that he encountered, because of which he had I think he lost around 2/10 per lap because of this. That was a disappointing performance by Bottas, and it would be hard to see what kind of an impact he makes, especially with the tendency of him going backwards in a race as compared to Sergio Perez, for instance. After Bottas, we had Charles Leclerc, P7 this time, and behind his teammate, which was a bit of a surprise, but it actually spices up the best of the rest competition between Norris, Sainz and Leclerc. It would be interesting to see who actually snatches that one. After Leclerc, we had Yuki Tsunoda, who's been one of the more impressive drivers this weekend, and well, one of the few drivers who would actually be starting the race on medium tires as compared to the soft tire that would be fitted by pretty much majority of the drivers in top 10. After Tsunoda, we had Esteban Ocon qualifying 9th, and then we had Daniel Ricciardo, arguably a disappointing P10 if you compare his results with Lando Norris, but still, at least he was part of the Q3 shootout. Now, talking about who really stood out in the qualifying session, then for me, the top 3 performers in qualifying, well, they have to be, well, first of all, it has to be Max Verstappen. That was a superb lap. Then it was Lando Norris, well, qualifying P3 ahead of both Sergio Perez and Valtteri Bottas. Now that's the sign of a driver who is going to make a huge impact next year, when the cars are actually expected to be much closer in terms of pace. After Lando, I have Yuki Tsunoda. Well, primarily because I think this is the first time Tsunoda has actually out-qualified Pierre Gasly. And more importantly, this is the first time Tsunoda in 22 races that Tsunoda is actually showing glimpses of what kind of a talent he is. And if he is able to keep up this kind of performance, I think we have a star for the future, because the kind of expectations Red Bull had from him, he hasn't really satisfied them this year. But the flashes and the talent, it is there. And I actually feel his performance this weekend, well, they are positive indications of what might be there in the future. Now, talking about the drivers who actually disappointed, I think the most disappointed I was with Charles Leclerc, and I've been disappointed with him the entire weekend. I don't think he has looked as comfortable as he usually does on a single lap. And qualifying P7 compared to his teammate Carlos Sainz qualifying P5, I think he will be disappointed. I don't think I need to point it out. I think he will be disappointed himself. And I expect Leclerc to bounce back and to actually, I expect him to finish ahead of Carlos Sainz in the race. But that is still a debate for the other day. Right now, P7 in a Ferrari, especially with Norris qualifying P3, I expected another special last minute Q3 lap from Leclerc, which somehow, well, it didn't materialize this weekend. So yeah, I'm a bit disappointed with him. After Leclerc, Daniel Ricciardo. I mean, it has pretty much been a season where Norris has outclassed Ricciardo like anything. Sure, last race Ricciardo lucked out and he was able to finish P5 at the Saudi Arabian Grand Prix. But let's be fair, even in that weekend, Norris was the better driver. And even here, Ricciardo is basically scraping through by the skin of his teeth, while Norris, well, he's pretty much fighting for pole in the same car. Such a result is not why McLaren signed the Australian. They signed him to win races, and yeah, he has done it at Imola, at Monza, but in many ways it has to be disappointing for Daniel to lose out by such a huge margin to Norris and not being able to figure out a Formula One car in an entire season. McLaren is not famous for being hard to drive, so it is slightly surprising to see the kind of struggle Ricciardo has had with the same car that is basically qualifying on the front row in the hands of another driver. Now after Ricciardo, well, yeah, I was slightly disappointed with Fernando Alonso as well. And yes, I feel he was blocked by the McLaren. I think it was Daniel Ricciardo who blocked him. Yeah, so I do feel that Alonso was partially blocked by Ricciardo. But having said that, I don't think it would have made a huge difference to his lap. And yeah, it's a game of small margins, but ultimately if you look at it, well, it's 12-10 to Esteban Ocon at the end of the season in qualifying. So somewhere down the line, Alonso, this season, I won't say he is back to his best, but some of the races, the kind of performance and the level of driving that he has shown, he surely is among the elites. I have to say that at 40 years old, there is something lagging, or either Esteban Ocon is too good. It has to be one of the two things, but I guess we'll have to wait for another season to finally figure that out. Now, moving on from this, I guess it's about time we had a look at what are the key talking points before the race starts tomorrow, and what would be the things that would actually be interesting and would be worth keeping an eye on, especially with the championship being at stake. And with Norris openly admitting that he would rather not want to get involved in the fight between Max and Lewis, I think there are quite a few key talking points that we need to discuss. Now, if we look at the starting grid, we have Max Verstappen starting on softs. Then we have Lewis Hamilton starting on mediums. Behind him, we have Lando Norris on softs and Sergio Perez on softs. Logically speaking, the softs should have a better launching grip as compared to the mediums. So by that measure, Max will ideally, he should not be troubled by Lewis Hamilton at the start of the race. Will that happen or not? I think starts are still unpredictable. Anything can happen. But the biggest worry that might be there for Hamilton is the fact that he is currently surrounded by pretty much three drivers who are starting on softs. And if Max is able to pull away at the start of the race, and if either of Norris or Perez is able to jump Lewis Hamilton, then that, in many ways, that could cost Hamilton time and could actually work in favor of Max, as these drivers, well, they could work, they could basically play the role of a roadblock and could actually be a cause of concern, because after looking at the track and after looking at the F2 races, I don't think the track has become too conducive for overtakes. I still feel there are still going to be the same issues when it comes to overtaking. I don't think there's going to be a huge difference on that front. So overtaking might not be the easiest of things, and you might find Hamilton struggling behind both the McLaren and the Red Bull if somehow they are able to get a better start compared to him. Now coming to the soft tire, I guess it is going to be the biggest talking point before the race, because, well, first of all, it might have the initial grip, but it will not have the longevity. And in many ways, it pretty much appeared that even during the simulations, the soft tire is not the best race tire if you compare it to the medium tire. So how much of an impact will that have, and how much of a life can Max and even Sergio Perez extract from the soft tire if you compare it with Hamilton, who might struggle a bit off the line on the mediums but could have an advantage later in the race when Max might suffer from tire degradation because of using a comparatively softer compound as compared to Hamilton. Now, I found it slightly annoying to hear something like this, but a slightly shocking revelation from Lando Norris was a bit surprising for me as well. But to hear a young driver worry about racing the two championship contenders for the fear of controversies that might arise, I think that's rubbish. I don't think a driver of Norris's caliber, and arguably someone who is going to be a potential future world champion, someone of that caliber, I don't think he should be worried about the fact that he might face controversy if he fights hard with Max or Lewis Hamilton. I think at this stage it would be slightly surprising to see Norris basically letting Hamilton go and fight Max if somehow he's able to get a better start compared to Hamilton. On the other hand, Norris might actually turn to be the biggest thorn in the flesh for Red Bull if somehow the running order after the first few laps appears to be Max, Hamilton, Norris and Perez. Because in that scenario, Sergio Perez will be stuck behind Lando and he will not be able to pressurize Hamilton into a particular strategy. Now, I feel this has to be one of the talking points once the layout was changed at Abu Dhabi, because Abu Dhabi is not famous for safety cars. Of course, yeah, there was one famous safety car when Raikkonen won in 2013, but more often than not, you don't really see safety cars in Abu Dhabi because of such large runoff areas available for the drivers to, you know, whenever they make a mistake, either they are able to still continue or those cars that actually get damaged, they can be easily lifted off without causing a disruption in the race. However, with the new layout, I feel there is one thing that has changed, and that is the risk that was there in the third sector. Raikkonen has already crashed in S3, and other than him, even Valtteri Bottas has brushed the wall. Today in qualifying, Sebastian Vettel did the same. In many ways, by speeding up and smoothing the edges of the third sector, what they have done is made it a bit more trickier and also made it more conducive to crashes. So if we are going to see a safety car, I think that is going to be a result of either of the drivers making a mistake and crashing into the wall in the third sector. Other than that, I expect a pretty straightforward race in the start. I don't expect too many collisions in the start, and I really don't expect too much action on that front when it comes to a safety car or a red flag on a track like Abu Dhabi, where, well, the track layout as well as the surroundings, they are conducive for stoppage free racing, if I might say. And that has been, well, it has been on evidence in the last few years. We didn't have a safety car in 2019, we didn't have one in 2020, and well, it's tough to remember the last time actually there was one. So yeah, when it comes to the safety car and it having a deciding role in the race, I think that might not be the case. And safe to say that we'll have pretty much a stoppage free race, and it will ultimately come down to the strategy and the thinking on the feet that both Red Bull and Mercedes will be trying to do. So yeah, these are my views. Do share what you guys think in the comment section, and thanks for watching. Please like, share, subscribe. Hope we have a great race tomorrow, and so yeah, thank you, take care, bye bye.